So good morning. Today we are going to see about asynchronous motor drives. I am Dr. Lennon, Associate Professor, School of Electrical Engineering, NVIT University, Chennai. So as far as control systems are concerned, permanent magnets and synchronous machine. So the advanced machine at present day situation is the permanent magnet synchronous machine. So this drive, with known as references in control literature, is going to drive between torque and mutual linkages commands. They can be independent inputs, as in the case of torque controlled motor drive in an electric propulsion application, or can be part of a speed control drive's dependent and internal variable. So if you see the torque equation, it is going to be 3 by 2 T by 2 into lambda A IS sin del plus of LD by minus LQ IS the whole square sin 2 del. So if you simplify that, so we get a torque equation like this with making this machine dependent on torque angle. Suppose if this angle is going to be 90 degree, then the torque is going to be maximum. So in order to obtain the torque angle reference, so we have we need to do few analytical solutions. So one is the flux producing component of the stator current is solved from the second expression of the equation, so that is this equation. So once if you solve that, so we get a equation for IS cos del, then the stator current reference is obtained from the final expression in the equation here. So from that you obtained what is IS, that is stator current, reference stator current. So based on that, so your torque and flux linkage is going to be the input for a current and torque angle calculator, and the current and torque angle calculator calculates the reference stator current and torque angle, which is going to fed back to the stator current synthesizer, which makes your three phase current with appropriate delay and so which is going to be the input to the inverter with current control. So the inverter is going to drive the PM machine. And the position sensor is used to sensing the signal, either a torque or current or speed. And the signal conditioner is used to reduce the harmonics in that one. And the reference signal is given to the input to the to obtain the actual current angle.
So, based on the dynamic performance of this torque control drive with PWM control, so if you see this, so this is the command, torque command, and this is the actual torque, and this is the required speed, the synchronous speed is here, and this is the torque angle. Similarly, IQ stator current and reference current is coincide with each other.
So this figure shows the speed control drive system of the synchronous machine. So if you see the speed controller, so we have a reference speed and we have a actual speed which is obtained from the position sensor, that is which we generally called as outer loop control, whereas the current control scheme is going to be the inner loop control. So based on the reference speed and the actual speed, the torque command is obtained, and based on the speed function program and the constant, we obtain the flux linkage which is going to the input to the current and torque angle calculator. So if you see here, so for these two things, if you use the speed controller, external speed controller, external loop, then these two things is going to be the input for the current and torque angle, and other things remains as it is. That is, this is the torque drive and this is the speed controller. So the function generator operating on the speed has the following characteristics: f of omega bm equal to omega b base speed by reference speed. So if the reference speed is lesser or equal to omega base speed, and lesser or equal plus or minus omega max, and the power developed by the machine is given by the product of omega m into te, and if you substitute for this one, this is force, and if you substitute for torque, you get the final equation like that. So this is the graph, simulated graph obtained during a speed drive performance with flux weakening control. So usually these machines are preferred in flux weakening control, whereas it's a quite difficult thing to operate your PMS in a flux weakening region. So operating in flux weakening region, so this one is going to be a critical stage as far as permanent magnets and pressure drives are concerned. So there are numerous techniques to control the torque as well as speed as well as current in permanent magnets and pressure machine. So one of the significant development in PMSM towards real-time application is vector control, and which proves and provides a decoupling between the torque and flux channels in the PMSM. So such decoupling need not be the only performance requirement for a drive system. The performance measures can be a simpler control strategy or otherwise an optimum torque per unit current. Likewise, we have different control schemes. So now we are going to see about different control strategies which are going to use appropriately for this permanent magnet synchronous drives. So these are the seven different control strategies are considered for optimal control of torque, current, flux linkage, position, everything for a permanent magnet synchronous drive. So we have a constant torque angle control or zero direct axis current control, unity power factor control, constant mutual air gap flux linkage control, angle control of air gap flux and current phases, optimum torque per ampere control, constant loss based maximum torque speed boundary control, minimum loss or maximum efficiency control. So let us see one by one in a step by step manner how these control algorithms are useful to control the PMSM drive. So let us start with the constant torque angle control. So as I already suggest that always if the torque angle is going to be 90 degree, your torque is going to be maximum. So maintaining this torque angle 90 is going to be a critical stage in your PMSM drive. So the torque equation here in 4.27 torque equation is given. So from that, where IS is the magnitude of the stator current phase, the torque per unit stator current is constant and given by TE by IS equals from here. So 3 by 2 P by 2 lambda AF. This is torque is Newton meter and the current is ampere. And the normalized electromagnetic torque is actual by base value. So this is the actual value and this is the base value which is going to be normalized current. So from that we know what is VQS, Q-axis stator and D-axis stator with reference to the rotor reference frame. So note that the rate of change of current is zero in the rotor reference frame as they are constant in steady state. The magnitude of stator voltage phasor is given by Vs equal to root VQS whole square plus VDS whole square, and this all represents rotor reference frames. And Vs is the normalized units, it is obtained by combining equations 4.29 and 4.31, and Vsn is going to be this equation 4.33. So from the phasor diagram here, the quadrature and direct axis, so this is your quadrature axis, this is your direct axis. The power factor is obtained by exploiting the fact that the quadrature stator current is in phase with the quadrature axis stator voltage. So this is going to be your power factor. So once if you maintain this del at 90 degree, so then obviously the electromagnetic torque produced by the PMSM drive is going to be optimal one. So the next control we are having is unity power factor control. A unity power factor control implies that the volt ampere rating of the inverter is fully utilized for the real power input to the PMSM. The unity power factor control is enforced by controlling the torque angle as a function of the motor variables. The performance equation in this mode of operation are derived and given as Q-axis current and D-axis current with reference to the rotor reference frame. So if you see this, in this case, So your maximum up to 0.5, it is going to be the constant torque region, and after that it is going to be the constant power region. So from that you find the Q and D axis normalized stator voltages, VQ and VD, and find the normalized stator and angle between D axis and the resultant voltage, tan of del plus phi, that is VQS divided by VDS. Since the power factor angle has to be zero in this control, that is the power factor angle here, if you see this one, so this is the power factor angle. So if this becomes zero, then tan del equals gives VQ by VD. So tan is going to be sine by cos, and VQ by substitute for VQ VS, and find what is cos del, and from that you find what is del. So once if you find del value based on the inductance, Q axis inductance and D axis inductance, then note that the LDN minus LQN is negative, because this is going to be greater, and the torque angle has to be greater than 90 degree. If the torque angle is less than 90 degree, it will result in an increase of mutual flux linkage contributing to a saturation in the machine, which is undesirable from the point of view of losses. Therefore, only a positive sign in equation 4 here, the positive sign in equation 4.50 will satisfy the requirement of del greater than 90 degree. This expression provides the enforcement of the UPF control, and its implementation requires the motor phase current magnitude and motor parameters LQ and LD. So if you see this, you can get a in-depth understanding of what about the power factor, normalized source, stator voltage, torque angle, torque, electromagnetic torque with respect to the current. So the third control method we are going to see is constant mutual flux linkage method. In this control strategy, the resultant flux linkages of the stator, curvature and direct axis and rotor, known as mutual flux linkages, is maintained at a constant, and most usually at a value equal to the rotor flux linkages. Its main advantage is that by limiting the mutual flux linkages, the stator voltage requirement is kept comparably low. In addition, the varying mutual flux linkages provides a simple and straightforward flux weakening for operation at speeds higher than the base speed. Hence, the mutual flux linkages control is one of the powerful techniques useful in the entire speed range as against other schemes, which are limited to operations below the base speed only. The mutual flux linkages are expressed as lambda m equals root of lambda af plus ld ids whole square plus lq iq s whole square. And equating the lambda m equals lambda af and substituting the direct and quadrature axis current with the saliency ratio ld by lq by ld, two distinct cases arises here depending on the saliency ratio. The surface mounted magnets is around unity, and for a buried inter or IPM magnet, it could have less value as high as could have values as high as 3. Much higher values have been achieved in special designs. These two cases are analyzed separately here. When saliency ratio equals 1, that is the surface mounted magnets, then your torque angle, that is tan del, del equals cos inverse minus LDIS minus 2 divided by 2 lambda AF. The base voltage is defined as omega B lambda AF, and base impedance is omega B LB, which is equals VB by LB. If you substitute here omega B, it is going to be VB by LIB. Using this for normalization of the motor current, the torque angle is given by cos inverse of minus LDIB into IS by IB divided by 2 lambda F equals cos inverse minus ISN LDN divided by 2, which is in radians. When the saliency ratio is not equal to 1, that is the interior permanent magnet machine, this yields the torque angle as del equals cos inverse of 1 by LDN ISN 1 minus rho square plus or minus this thing. So if you see this and if you compare with the previous control strategy of unity power factor control, here the graphs is not smooth as much as smooth when compared with the unity power factor control. So one of the biggest advantage with the unity power factor control, because here the cos phi value is not the phi angle is not maintained zero throughout the analysis, so you didn't get the exact smooth curve characteristics of each and every case. So let us come for next control technique, that is torque per unit current control. So if you see the torque, the control strategy of this optimum torque per unit current control is used to maximize electromagnetic torque for a unit stator current is valuable from the optimum machine and inverter utilization points of view. As in other control strategies, this control strategy is enforced with a torque angle control. The torque angle for a given stator current magnitude for this control strategy is derived as follows. The electromagnetic torque is given by 4.67, and which in normalized term it is given as normalized inductance and Q axis and D axis inductor. The base torque is defined by 3/2 T/2 lambda A phi B. The torque per unit stator current is given by TN divided by ISN equals sin del plus 1/2 LDN minus LQN into ISN sin 2 del. Its maximum is formed by differentiating with respect to del and equating it to 0 to obtain the condition for torque angle as del equals cos inverse of minus 1/4 A1 plus left hand side. Only the positive sign in the argument is considered as del. Del has to be greater than 90 degree to reduce the field in the air gap. To illustrate the superior performance of this control against constant torque, the torque versus stator current is shown in figure. It has 3.2% and 11.05% torque enhancement for 1 and 2 per unit stator currents. So if you see this one and compare with unity power factor control technique, this one, so it is easy to understand that this command, it has 3.2% and 11.05% torque enhancement for 1 and 2 per unit stator currents. So the torque enhancement due to higher saliency ratios and maximum torque unit stator current control is illustrated here. So for different saliency ratio, so your maximum torque per unit stator current is illustrated here. So if you keep on increasing the normalized stator current, so with respect to increasing in the saliency ratio, the torque is also get increased. So the here the direct axis inductance is taken as the base inductance and the rotor flux linkage. So this is normalized torque versus stator current for various saliency ratio. So this is going to be the saliency ratio, and this is stator current and electromagnetic torque. So the next control strategy we are going to see is maximum efficiency control. So a control strategy minimizing the total electrical losses at all operating point is a good candidate in many applications where a maximum efficiency operation is required. Such application can be found predominantly in heating, ventilation and air conditioning and home appliances such as washers, dryers, freezers, refrigerators and battery operated hand tools, garden tools and vacuum cleaners. In all other high performance applications, maximization of efficiency enables higher thermal robustness and hence a longer life for the machine insulation, resulting in a high operational reliability of the motor drive system. So if you see this graph, this is the torque angle with respect to the electromagnetic torque. So obviously greater than 90 degree the torque is going to be maximum, and if you see the losses for different current, so these are the losses plot for different current with respect to the with a different torque.
So this is the block diagram for loss minimization control schematic for the PMSM drive system during the flux weakening mode, and although the concept is simple, it is not feasible to have a simple algorithm for implementing this strategy online. The minimum loss for every operating point is computed offline and then could be loaded into tables for efficient use in the implementation. This approach seems to be the most feasible at present. Similar to fuzzy logic techniques adapted in induction motor loss minimization,
An equivalent approach is feasible for the PMSM drive. The incorporation of the maximum efficiency control is shown in this one. So if you see here, this is going to be the actual speed and this is going to be the reference speed, and with hysteresis control it is going to produce a reference current and actual field current. So from that, three phase current is obtained from the rotor to stator transformation, two phase to three phase transformation, and this current is going to be the input to the inverter system, and inverter is going to operate your PMSM, and this encoder is used to get the feedback signal from the drive system. So although this control algorithm is going to difficult to implement, usually as far as PMSM drive is concerned, most of the applications prefer torque per unit control and as well as unity power factor control and constant torque angle control. Constant torque angle control, unity power factor control, and torque per ampere control are the three techniques those control strategies are widely used for most of the applications, including automotive high performance applications. So thanks for watching. Bye.